It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. But her mommy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen. Now she walks through a sunken dream to the seat with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen. And the film is a saddening bore, for she's lived it 10 times or more. But she can spit in the eyes of fools as they ask her to focus on sailors dancing in the dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. Every year there's a show. Take a look at the old man beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if he'll ever know. Is it better in a show? Is it life on Well, Heidi there, Pluckers, Other Sawfingers again, with a real classic song from David Bowie, of course, called Life on Mars, okay. Now then, this is quite a tricky song, so I am going to break the lesson down into a few parts, okay. What you heard there was a sort of shortened version of a song. Basically, the whole thing repeats itself, and in between the two bits, there's a small instrumental bit, okay, which I shall cover later on in the lessons, okay. So the first part I'm going to show you is basically the verse and the pre-chorus, okay, in lesson one, okay. Standard tuning, no capos, as you can see. I'm doing it in the key of D, okay. If you want to play along with David Bowie, I think he originally did it in the key of F, okay. So you would need, if you're going to use the chords I'm using, you'd need to put a capo on the 3rd fret and then play everything I'm about to show you, the D shape, etc., E minor, etc., etc. Just put a capo on the 3rd fret and you should be roughly in tune with David Bowie's original version. Although I've seen him do a live version at Glastonbury, I think it was, and he was in the key of C, so who knows, okay. Anyway, so this is, for simplicity, I'm doing it in D, okay. So, starting off into the D chords, right. It's a god of a small affair. Now, the chords I'm using are obviously, this song is very piano-based. And this, obviously it's quite difficult to replicate a piano with the guitar, because they can play obviously with two hands and bass notes that you can't do and all this sort of thing. So this is my version, my take on, as best as I can get it close to the record on a single acoustic guitar, okay. So starting off with a D, then I put my pinky up to the 4th fret on the 5th string and you hit that, keeping the D shape, so it's a god-awful small affair. What I'm doing there is I'm playing a D chord but with a C note, with the, so the 3rd fret of the 5th string with the 2nd finger. So what I'm playing a standard D, then D with pinky on the 4th fret of the 5th string, emphasizing that note first, and then I'm taking this first part of the D off and just barring the 1st 3 strings with the 1st finger, keeping the 3rd finger where it is on that 3rd fret of the 2nd string there, the B string. So it's a D chord but with a bar on the 1st 3 strings for the first, and then this 2nd finger goes up to the 3rd fret on the 5th string and you hit that note and strum the D, okay? So that's another way of playing D, okay? So it's D with C in the bass. Okay, so you've got, it's a god-awful small affair. Okay, then we go to a B7th, okay, and hit the B note, the second on the fifth, on the B7. Okay, so it's a god awful small affair to the girl with a mousy, and then here is E minor. And again, try and emphasize that second fret of the fourth string or the bottom E string. That's a nice E note as well. So the girl with the mousy hair. Then remove the third finger from the E minor, open up the fourth string, play the fourth string open, and then the chord. Okay, so it's like an E minor seventh. Okay, so far. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. Her mummy is yelling. Okay, and then we go to where it goes, her mother is yelling no on no. I'm playing this chord. Two fingers. First finger is playing the second on the fourth. And my third finger is playing the fourth fret of the fifth string. So third string, second string and top E string are all open. You go five down to one. Don't bother with the top bottom E string. Five down to one. Okay, I'm not hitting the bottom E string, okay? So now we've got this. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with a mousy hair, but her mummy is yelling. Okay, and then her daddy is a straightforward A chord and hitting the fifth string open first. Okay, so now we've got it's a god-awful small affair to the girl with a mousy hair, but her mummy is yelling no and her daddy is telling her to. Then we repeat the whole thing. Go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen as she walks through a sunken dream to a simple but clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver. Okay, and then we go in into the pre-chorus. So two lots of the same thing. Okay, so once again, slowly, I'll play it very slowly from the beginning. It's quite slow anyway. Don't rush it. Okay, there's no panic here. So here we go. It's a quick strum to just lead you in. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair, but her mummy is yelling no and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen, now she walks through a drunken dream, the secret, the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver. And then we go into the pre-chorus, and it's an F chord. I'm playing a four-fingered variety because I'm hitting that fifth string first. Fifth string. So it's a basic F chord, but this third finger goes up to the fifth string on the third fret. And the pinky takes over on the fourth string on the third fret. It's an F with C in the bass, okay? So when you come out of that A, where it goes, here is view, as you come to the screen, you play that fifth string, and you play, then you play the F. So, look and dream, to the sea with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen, and the film is sadly born. Right, then after the F, we play a C sharp augmented. Okay, that's on this chord. I'm barring the third string and the second string on the second fret with my first finger. Okay, second finger is playing the third fret of the fourth string, the D string. And my third finger is playing the fourth fret of the fifth string, the A string, yeah? And I'm just going five down to two. So it goes, so you play the C note and then the F, the fifth, third on the fifth and then the F. And then you go up to this F, sorry, C sharp, Cecil, sorry, tongue tied, C sharp augmented, and you hit that fourth on the fifth first, because it's like a climbing bass. You got, okay, so, and then it goes into D minor. So we play the D string open, and then the minor, okay? So coming out of that second verse, I do the second verse up to that point, okay, where it goes, second half of the verse, shall we call it then, where it goes, but her friend is nowhere to be seen, but she walks her own sunken dream to a super clearest view. And she's hooked to the silver screen, but the film is a sadly bore. Got that? Got that climb, the F, with the third on the fifth. Then the fourth on the fifth with the C sharp augmented. And then the D open and the D minor. Okay. Then I'm playing an F7. Okay. Two ways you can play this. I was playing it on the demo. I did it as a bar chord. F chord with pinky off, so it's like F, C sharp augmented, D minor, and then the F7. Okay, that's one way you can play the F7. The other way is just to bar the first four strings on the first fret with your first finger, and add your third finger, or second finger, whichever is more comfortable, to the second fret on the third string. And you play four down to one. So then you've got F, C sharp augmented, D minor, F7th, hitting that first on the fourth first, right? Or you can just play the bar chord F7, whichever you find easier or sounds better to yourself, okay? So we've got where it goes, moved on a silver screen, the film is a sadly bore, for she's lived in his times. Or, and then I'm going up to a B flat. Again, two ways you can play that, 6th fret major shape bar chord, or you can play a B flat down here, first fret bar, and barring the third fret of the fourth, third, and second strings, or three fingers. Or you can play a simple B flat like that, first fret, top E string, and then the third fret of the fourth, third, and second strings with your other three fingers. So that way, or bar chord on the 6th fret major shape, which is the one I was using, but you can play whichever one you want, okay? So far, let's go from the end of the second half of the first verse. That goes where it goes. But her friend is nowhere to be seen, now she walks through a sunken dream, and she's up to the silver screen, but the film is a sadly bore, for she's lived with it 10 times or more. Sorry. Okay, up to that one on bore. Sorry, any 10 times or more. Then you could go, she could spit. And that's another augmented chord. This time we're playing an F sharp. It's basically the same chord as you played before. That one, but it's up one fret. Same shape. Barring, now we're playing first fingers borrowing the third fret of the third string and second string. Second fingers playing the fourth fret of the fourth string, the D string, and third fingers playing the fifth fret of the fifth string, the A string. Five down to two again. So now you've got F, C sharp augmented, D minor, whichever version of F7 you want to play, B flat, again, whichever one of B flat you want to play. Then we play this F sharp augmented. And then we play G minor. Okay, just a straightforward G minor. So that's the first three frets, sorry, b- barring the first three strings on the third fret with your first finger. Simple G minor is just play the fifth fret of the fourth string with your third finger, four down to one. Or you could play extended version, third finger on the fifth fret of the fifth string, pinky on the fifth fret of the fourth string, or a full bar chord, whichever one you want, okay, you'll find easier. So now we've got F, C sharp augmented, a D minor, an F7, whichever version you want, a B flat, whichever version you want, then this F sharp augmented, then the G minor, and finally a B flat 7. Now I was using the bar chord B flat again with pinky off this time. Okay, so I just run through that whole thing up to this point, okay, from the halfway through the first verse where it goes, but a friend is nowhere to be seen. Now she walks through a sunken dream to the seat with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen. The film is a sad label, but she's lived it 10 times or more, because spilled her eyes are fools, and they ask her to focus on. And then we're going into the chorus, and that's where I'll stop for now, because I don't want to go too crazy and blow your mind, okay? So, have you got that? Okay. I think I forgot to tell you something. That chord there, that one there, I forgot to give you a name, didn't I? I think I did, anyway. That chord is an E minor 6, where you're playing the 2nd on the 4th and the 4th on the 5th there. 3rd string, 2nd string and top E string open, 5 down to 1. That's an E minor 6 with C sharp in the bass, okay? Or E minor 6 over C sharp, whichever you want to call it. So we'll just go through the whole thing that we've done today, okay, so far in lesson 1. Okay, so this is not the easiest song. Here we go. It's a god awful small affair to the girl with the messy hair. But her mommy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be. Oh, I've gone wrong. Sorry. Let's do that again. I lost myself. Oh dear. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. But her mommy is yelling no, and her daddy has told her to go. But her friend is nowhere to be seen, but she walks through a sunken dream to the seat with the clearest view, and she's hooked to the silver screen. The film is a saddening bore, for she's lived it 10 times or more. She could spin the eyes of fools as they ask her to focus on. And we're obviously going into sailors fighting in the dance halls coming next, okay? But that is in the next lesson, boys and girls, okay? So hopefully you make some sense out of that. Okay, thanks very much for watching and listening, and hopefully see you in part 2. Bye for now.